All right, let's talk about what is happening right now in Ukraine with CNN military analyst, retired Air Force Colonel Cedric Leighton. Let's talk first about Kreminna, Colonel, and what this means that Russians are now in control of it.
Yeah, and this is actually a very interesting piece, Brianna, because Kreminna is right here. So if you look at where it is, it's right by the Donbas region, and it's right on the edge of where the Russian forces are right now. So this advance is not a major advance in terms of the kinds of movements that the Russians will have to make in order to capture more of the Donbas, but it is a key element in their way to doing that. So what they're doing is they're moving through here. One of the key things to note, though, Kreminna is actually a city that was run by a pro-Russian mayor before he was killed earlier this year. So these kinds of movements here are in some ways revenge, probably, for that killing. In other ways, it's also a way for, from a tactical military standpoint, for the Russians to move forward into a region where they can then control the rest of the Donbas.
Let's talk about Lviv now. Lviv has been so safe there on the west. And I like to remind people that if you were to turn California on its side, that distance is about the same of how wide Ukraine is. This is a very, very wide nation here. And Lviv is very far in the west there, away from the front. And yet here we saw a strike on a civilian target. And we haven't seen that before, Cedric.
That's right, Brianna. And, you know, what's key here, you had mentioned earlier, it's so close to the Polish border. It's about 40 miles from Lviv to Poland, which is also 40 miles to NATO. So when the Russians are looking at targeting these particular areas, not only are they looking at critical infrastructure in terms of, you know, hitting major cities like Kyiv, but Lviv is not only a major city, it has a few installations and it is critical to the Western resupply effort for the Ukrainians. A lot of stuff goes through Lviv. And the idea that the Russians have is of not only spreading terror, as Jim mentioned in his reporting from there, but it also shows a key element in going after the civilian population. We're going after them not only in their daily lives, but in their ability to function and their ability to carry out things like, you know, moving around, like even potentially escaping. So what the Russians are trying to do is they're trying to cut off all means of supply around here and in other areas too. And when they do this kind of thing, they are doing it in a way so that the rest of the civilian population is cowed and, in essence, prevented from doing what they need to do. And it could also prevent the Ukrainian military from moving into other areas.
Do you think the Russians can effectively do that? I mean, Lviv, which is obviously so far away from Russia, there's not pro-Russian sentiment there. So, you know, they're able to keep secret, I think, more of what they are doing there in that region.
I think that's very true. Yes, it's a very different Ukraine in the western part of the country as opposed to the east. And, you know, if you look at the broader map here, what you see is, you know, more or less in the past, before the invasion, pro-Russian areas kind of in here, pro-Western areas right in through this area. And what that really means is these are different parts of the same country. And the other thing to keep in mind is the areas that were once pro-Russian are no longer as pro-Russian as they once were. A lot of this is changing politically. That means a lot for the Ukrainians, and it also will prevent the Russians from achieving their goals. The Ukrainians see what's going on here. They are going to be, the resolve is going to be stiffened, and they're going to fight more than they have in the past. Not to say anything about what they've done in the past, because it's been actually phenomenal, but this stiffens their resolve, and they're coming into this with a really hardened attitude toward the Russian and the potential Russian occupation.
Yeah, they certainly are. Colonel, thank you so much for taking us through that. We do appreciate it.